Okay?
Okay, Morgan.
Okay. Good evening, everyone. I'm Paul Herriott. Welcome to the National Concert Hall and to RTE Lyric Live with the National Symphony Orchestra, and a very significant occasion tonight that requires the words of another. I have learned that people may forget what you have said. They may even forget what you have done, but they will never forget the way you made them feel. Now, this Tuesday, we mark International Women's Day, and those are the words of an extraordinary woman, Dr. Maya Angelou. Maya Angelou, the human rights activist, poet, writer, actor, you name it, and indeed, sometimes composer herself. Well, she might well have been speaking on behalf of our women composers this evening. It is perfectly possible, indeed, and particularly the earlier ones, perhaps the likes of Clara Schumann, who was very famously to remark at the beginning of her career, "They tell me that as a woman, I may not desire to compose, that there never has been one who is able to do so. Should I expect to be that one?" And in the event, of course, she went on to be not only a hugely significant composer, but the strength and stay of her more famous but frequently mentally vulnerable husband, Robert, a very principal influence upon the great Johannes Brahms, particularly in the early days of his career, and quite simply, one of the very greatest pianists of the entire Romantic era. In other words, she was a trailblazer for the women composers whose music we are going to hear this evening, beginning with another champion from the earlier years of the 19th century, the equally great Fanny Mendelssohn, of course, sister of the famous Felix Mendelssohn, and who again, we're told, struggled her entire life with the conflicting impulses of authorship versus the social expectations of the era through which she lived. But she did not let it stop her, and it is more than appropriate that our overture this evening belongs to her, her overture in C. But before we hear that, and in solidarity this evening to our friends, our colleagues, the people of Ukraine who are so much who are so very much in our minds at this time, we are going to hear that country's national anthem performed by our own National Symphony Orchestra with leader Elaine Clark. And now for our conductor this evening, a brilliant young woman, no stranger to these shores. She's been here recently conducting the Irish National Opera Orchestra with Peter Maxwell Davis's The Lighthouse, and will return later this year for a major production of Tosca, once again with Irish National Opera. And so we are delighted that she is here with us this evening. Will you please welcome Nil Venditti.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, beautiful people. I'm thrilled to welcome you in this beautiful hall with the scholars for our friends and colleagues from Ukraine with this orchestra. I mean, did you hear how they play? Right? Right? Yeah. I wanted to talk a little bit about the next piece, Cécile Chaminade, the concertino for flute. Now, you know, we are all here celebrating the Women's Day. We have a women conductor, we have a woman solo that I will introduce, and we have all women composers in the program. And I mean, you know, every positive adjective that you will throw to woman, I will take it. I mean, bring it on. I mean, women are beautiful, charming, clever, strong, independent. I mean, bring it on, I'll take it. But for this piece, I wanted to underline another characteristic of women, which comes out when women get hurt. Because, as an example, you know, when guys get hurt, they're in your face, they're straightforward. They will punch you in your face. I mean, and then we're even, let's have lunch together and easy peasy, that's it. But girls, when we get hurt, we plan it for months. Right? Every detail, we imagine every possible scenario in order to find the exact moment to strike. And I mean, I love it, I'm so proud of this, I just love it, but it's so funny, right? It's so funny. And why am I saying this? Because Cécile Chaminade wrote this concertino for her lover. He was the first flute of an orchestra, now I can't remember the name, it's not important. And then, so she writes this piece for him, but he's marrying another girl. So she crashes the wedding and gives this piece to him as a wedding gift. So funny, I just love it. It's just so well thought. And okay, after this they're silent, and later on, after a couple of days, Cecile receives a formal thank you from her mother-in-law. A formal thank you, and behind this page there is a death threat. Just so funny, I love it. And in order to accompany us in this journey of love and irony, we will have our wonderful Catriona Ryan.
This is not a woman who composes, but a composer who is a woman. Ambroise Thomas describing his compatriot, the French composer and pianist, Cécile Chaminade. Chaminade, who would go on to become the first woman ever to be awarded her country's highest honor, the Légion d'honneur, back in 1913, her concertino for flute in D major from 1902, a particular highlight in an active and influential career, and one that endures to this day as not only one of her most popular works, but a resolute staple within the flautist's repertoire. Applause not only for her, but rapturous applause for our flautist today, none other than Catriona Ryan. Magnificent performance there with Catriona Ryan, of course, principal flautist with the National Symphony Orchestra, and joining her colleagues there with leader Elaine Clark under the direction this evening of Nil Venditti, our conductor. Well, we move on to our next woman composer tonight as we mark International Women's Day coming up this Tuesday, a member of the Viennese aristocracy. Marianne Martinez, born in 1744, will always be remembered for having given us the one and only symphony, as it happens, composed by a woman during what we would think of as the classical era. But she was also a highly accomplished writer of several large-scale vocal works. She composed two oratorio, wrote the libretti, as well as a number of secular cantatas, was a renowned singer herself when she found the time, could play the harpsichord, spoke several languages, and performed frequently for the Empress Maria Theresa herself. She also knew Haydn and Mozart well, and in 1773 was one of the chosen few to gain entry to the prestigious Accademia Filarmonica, the Philharmonic Academy of Bologna, for whom she composed a setting of the Dixit Dominus. Well, those are the facts. Now we're going to enjoy the evidence with this next work, her Overture to Isacco, Figura del Redentore. Once again, the National Symphony Orchestra, directed by Nil Venditti. Thank you. A member of the Viennese aristocracy, Marianne Martinez, born in 1744 and who knew both Haydn and Mozart, and who will always be remembered for having given us one of the only symphonies really to be composed by a woman during the classical era, but also a highly accomplished writer of large-scale vocal works. Although her endeavours lay in obscurity after her death in 1812 for many years, but it is a contribution that has been reassessed in more recent times. And today, as we anticipate, mark International Women's Day for next Tuesday, we were reminded just there of Marianne Martinez's overture to Isacco, Figura del Redentore, with the National Symphony Orchestra and leader Elaine Clark, under the direction this evening of Nil Venditti.
Rona Clark's Requiem, a work she began to compose in March 2020, at the time, of course, of the COVID-19 restrictions at their very height. Well, Rona says that the choice of text had nothing to do with the pandemic. It was simply a text that she'd long wanted to set. And we heard it there in that recording performed by the Latvian State Choir under the direction of Maris Sirmas.
Paul Herriott welcoming you back to the National Concert Hall here in Dublin and to the second half of RT Lyric Live with the National Symphony Orchestra marking International Women's Day this Tuesday with our composers this evening down the centuries since Clara Schumann was famously to ask the question, should I expect to be the one? Well, we're going to continue with music very shortly from Ina Boyle, the Irish composer born in Enniskerry, County Wicklow. Her father was the curate in St. Patrick's in Parr's Court, and hers would have been considered to be a relatively sheltered upbringing. But her music was far-reaching, although much of her training was carried out through correspondence. She would travel to London on a frequent basis to study under the great British composer and ethnomusicologist Ralph Vaughan Williams. We're going to hear one of her more famous works, The Magic Harp, very shortly. But we begin with a work, well, I was going to say fanfare, but quite honestly, I think that is a bit of an understatement when you hear this extraordinary work by the great American composer Joan Tarr. Everything about this woman, including her name, is rather heroic in scale. Her music is very often inspired boldly by very large subjects. An early success for her back in the early 1970s was a tone poem entitled Sequoia, inspired by the giant Californian redwoods and describing their heroic status from their trunk to their very needles. Well, the next work that we're going to hear is a cleft of an equally heroic kind of form. And indeed, it's inspired by one of her most celebrated compatriots, the great Aaron Copland. However, this is Joan Tarr's Fanfare for the Uncommon Woman. Once again, the National Symphony Orchestra and leader Elaine Clark is conducted by Nil Venditti.
Thank you.
And the American composer Joan Tarr there providing us with our fanfare this evening, her fanfare for the uncommon woman, the National Symphony Orchestra and leader Elaine Clark, under the direction of Nil Venditti, as we anticipate International Women's Day this coming Tuesday. And our focus shifting to the gentler sensibilities now of Ina Boyle, the Irish composer from Enniskerry, and The Magic Harp, one of her best known works. Once again, the National Symphony Orchestra, to be conducted by Nil Venditti.
Thank you. Thank you.
The Magic Harp, that work by the Irish composer Ina Boyle from Enniskerry, County Wicklow, and who would emerge as one of the most significant and prolific female Irish composers of the early 20th century. The National Symphony Orchestra with leader Elaine Clark under the direction this evening of Nil Venditti in our concert devoted to women composers as we anticipate International Women's Day coming up on Tuesday. The National Symphony Orchestra, as I say, conducted by this extraordinary, brilliant young conductor this evening, who's going to grab the microphone.
How is it going? You know, I discovered in this country, you ask, how are you doing? But actually, you're not interested on how am I doing. Like, it's kind of, instead of hi, you know, which it's the English word I learned to say hi, you say, how are you doing? And just, it's very weird to me. But how are you doing? Nice, nice. I wanted to say a few words before the piece that we will play now, currently in show, Entr’acte. Because I wanted to create this family vibe between us. So you have to know that in the orchestra, the truthful soul of the orchestra are the strings. I liked it. And you know, when we had the pandemic, still going on. But when it started, suddenly time stopped, and when time stops. Because we have this life that we're always running here or there. And then when time stops, you actually get to think. And then I'm sure all of us realized at some point that there is an inner truth in each other's life, you know. And for Caroline Shaw, her truth are four notes. And exactly is ya-da-da-di. And the whole piece, it's built on this truth. And if we really, for a few minutes, just stop time, and listen, and try to understand what's the secret of Caroline Shaw with these three notes, it will be really something incredible. And mostly, I will end with a question. Is the ending of the piece a secret that it's hopeful or not? And I will leave the choice to you. Thank you very much.
Caroline Shaw, another of that newer generation of American composers, youngest recipient of the Pulitzer Prize for Music back in 2013, and her Entr’acte there from 2011, composed after hearing Haydn's string quartet, which she was to say of the Opus 77, number 2. I love the way some music like Haydn's minuets suddenly take you to the other side of Alice's looking glass in a kind of absurd, subtle technicolor transition. And there was the transition. The National Symphony Orchestra and leader Elaine Clark under the direction of Nil Venditti as we mark International Women's Day next Tuesday with a look to the future and Anna Clyne now, the English composer based in the United States. This is her Masquerade.
Thank you.
Such a spectacular flourish to conclude our concert tonight, as back in 2013, it was the English composer Anna Clyne's concert overture, Masquerade, that we heard just there, which was commissioned by BBC Radio 3 as the opening work for that season's Last Night of the Proms. And the conductor on that occasion, none other than Marin Alsop. So it's a very fitting conclusion, as I say, to our programme this evening, as we have paid tribute to all those women who, over the last two centuries and more, have played such a significant role in our musical world. The National Symphony Orchestra leader, Elaine Clark, under the direction this evening of our wonderful young Italian-Turkish conductor, Nil Venditti, who has, of course, conducted the Irish National Opera Orchestra and Peter Maxwell Davis's The Lighthouse, and who will be returning with them to conduct a major production of Tosca this summer. And I hope very much that we'll be bringing you that on Opera Night at some stage in the coming months. But a wonderful response from the audience here at the National Concert Hall to our extraordinary female roll call this evening. And I think also a great outpouring of affection, not only for the orchestra this evening, but for the extraordinary energy of our young conductor, Nil Venditti, who really enjoys performing in front of the crowd and completing that circle that exists between audience and orchestra. I do hope very much that you enjoyed listening to our concert tonight and our marking of International Women's Day, which will be this coming Tuesday, the 8th of February. And so on that note, I'm Paul Herriott, and on behalf of all of us here at the National Concert Hall in Dublin, that's our RTE Lyric Live with the National Symphony Orchestra. And goodbye.